9 most important reef tank aquarium parameters. Welcome to my channel. So before we get started with our video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you are new here, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so you never miss any update. Everyone loves adding fish, coral, and other invertebrates to their reef tanks. But before you can jump into that fun, you need to make sure you have your water on point. Reef tank water parameters are crucial for the health and well-being of everything you add to the aquarium. And it can feel overwhelming, but armed with all of the information, you'll find yourself testing and regulating your water conditions like a pro. So here are the 9 most important reef tank aquarium parameters. Number 9. Temperature. The 9th most important reef tank water parameter is temperature. The majority of animals we keep in our tanks come from tropical reefs, and tropical reefs tend to have a stable temperature between 22 to 29 degrees Celsius. If you live in an area where the ambient temperature matches that range, then you don't have to worry much. But if you don't live in an area with a steady tropical temperature, you will need equipment to keep the aquarium temperature in the right zone. An aquarium heater is required for just about any aquarium. Unfortunately, most of us live in houses where the daily temperature is lower than the ideal value. The aquarium heater raises the water temperature and helps keep it from falling below optimum levels. If you live in a warm climate, where the temperature gets above the ideal range, you may need an aquarium chiller. Since most of what we do is intended to recreate the natural environment our animal friends come from, it's no surprise the ideal recommended temperature for the saltwater in your reef tank is the same. As long as the temperature of your saltwater aquarium is in this range, keeping the temperature consistent becomes more important than the actual value itself. Number 8. Salinity. The 8th most important reef tank water parameter is salinity. Salinity is difficult to measure directly. One way to measure the salinity of the water is to completely evaporate a liter of salt water and weigh the salt left behind. That would be your salinity. However, it's not the most practical way to handle things with a reef tank. Luckily, some super smart people came up with a few super easy ways to estimate salinity. When the salinity of the water changes, two other things fluctuate at the same time: density and light refraction. So, aquarists use a hydrometer to measure the water's density. They also use a refractometer to measure the angle of light refraction to estimate the salinity. The most common type of hydrometer used in this hobby is called the swing arm model. You measure the salinity by submerging the device and filling it with your aquarium's water. The arm is carefully calibrated to float and point at the water's corresponding specific gravity and salinity. Ideally, you want to keep your aquarium reef at a specific gravity of 1.025. This is the simplest way to ensure the salinity replicates the salt concentration of a natural reef. Number 7. Phosphate. The 7th most important reef tank water parameter to monitor is phosphate. Phosphate occurs naturally on reefs and is present at a level of -0.13 parts per million. But phosphates in a saltwater aquarium can be a big-time troublemaker, even at natural levels. In your saltwater aquarium, phosphate acts as a fertilizer for algae. Determining the ideal level of phosphates for a reef tank is tricky. Since it fuels problem algae growth, you want to keep it low and may be tempted to keep it at or near zero. Number 6. pH level. The pH scale is logarithmic, meaning that 8.0 is much farther from 7.0 than you think. The way pH scale work is that it tells you the pH level of how acidic or not acidic the water is. The scale reads from acidic on the low end to basic on the high end. The pH is essential to the chemistry of your reef tank, which is why pH ranks as one of the most important reef tank parameters. The ideal range you want to aim for is 8.1 to 8.4 for a healthy saltwater aquarium. Number 5. Nitrite. The 5th most important saltwater aquarium water parameter is nitrite. Nitrite and nitrate are two separate and important compounds to monitor in your water. Nitrite is an intermediate byproduct produced by your bacterial filter as part of the nitrogen cycle. In your filter, bacteria convert toxic ammonia into less toxic nitrite before the second group of bacteria converts the nitrite to nitrate. For a very brief period of time, while you are cycling your tank, you look for the presence of nitrites in your tank. This provides evidence that naturally occurring, beneficial bacteria have colonized your tank. Other than that, you want your nitrites to remain as close to zero as possible. Number 4. Nitrate. The fourth most important water parameter for you to monitor in your reef tank is nitrate. Technically speaking, the presence of low levels of nitrates in your tank could be considered a good thing. It means your biological filter is working. In a properly cycled aquarium, bacteria convert nitrogen waste, often in the form of ammonia, into nitrite, then other bacteria turn that nitrite into nitrate. The problem crops up when your aquarium gets crowded and mature, more and more nitrate gets generated, allowing the levels to climb. It is best to keep nitrate levels as close to 0 parts per million in a saltwater aquarium, however, you may get away with slightly higher levels. Number 3. Calcium. Calcium is an essential element in a reef tank for small polyp stony or large polyp stony coral health. While the fish don't have bones, they have bony skeletons made from calcium, and they get that calcium from seawater. For that reason, calcium ranks third as the most important of the ideal reef tank aquarium water parameters and is especially critical for stony coral species like bird's nest, montipora, acropora, bonipora, favia, acans, and pretty much any other stony coral. The world's oceans tend to have reef calcium levels between 380 to 420 parts per million. The optimal reef tank calcium level is about 400 parts per million. Number 2. Ammonia. Ammonia occurs naturally as a byproduct of the organic waste breaking down in your tank. Ammonia gets into your reef tank when your fish pee and when food and other biological components like plants and live rock decompose. So it's perfectly natural to see it in your tank. The problem is ammonia is toxic waste in your aquarium. The ammonia in your tank will burn your saltwater fish and corals and possibly kill them if high enough. The good news is that a healthy, fully functioning biological filter protects your tank by removing ammonia from your water. However, if you have detectable ammonia levels in your tank, it means your aquarium is too new or you could have a problem with your biological filter. As another of the most important reef tank parameters, the ideal ammonia level for a reef aquarium is -0 parts per million. Number 1. Alkalinity. Why is alkalinity important in a reef tank? Alkalinity impacts the pH of the water. Alkalinity's role in affecting the available bicarbonate in your tank is also important because bicarb is one of the main ingredients used to build coral skeletons. Therefore, you need to keep alkalinity in the appropriate range in a reef tank to ensure sufficient bicarbonate for your corals to grow. The ideal alkalinity for a reef tank is 7 to 10 dKH, that's a pretty broad range. Perhaps more important than reaching a level within that range is trying to stay consistent once you find an alkalinity level that suits the inhabitants of your tank and is easy to maintain, based on your local water. Let us know what you think about the list in the comments section below. If you enjoy this video, please like the video and also subscribe to our channel. Thank you.